Welcome to the Grand Hotel.
Oh, great. Thanks. What a place you have here.
Listen, the flight here was a nightmare and not a vacation.
Outside the box. You know, people who want to make quick money, they're always making the same
I am
things.
At your service if you need
they
anything.
Only go for the short term. This is why there's constant flux in the economy. You know what I mean? Well, interesting story.
A normal person trying to make ends meet. Man, I get so happy. Where am I? But the day I feel my life living.
I've heard some of the sand crew talking about it. Apparently, they had this huge row in the middle of the night.
Cross and his manager fighting, huh? Well, bring on the gossip.
Well, I only picked up bits and pieces. Something about Miss Barrett confiscating an audio recording from Cross. Said it was for his own good, that listening to it had turned into an obsession. Hannah Highmore's name was mentioned.
The girlfriend who died?
Yeah, but you don't believe all that crap, do you? That Cross killed his girlfriend.
Well, my brother is an officer.
The plot thickens. Apparently, Jordan Cross has been obsessing over a mysterious audio recording featuring the voice of Hannah Highmore. However, his manager, Dexie Barrett, has confiscated the recording for her client's own good. Well, I suggest you get a hold of that recording, 47. Sounds like the perfect bait, and if my hunch is right, a chance to confront Cross with his crimes.
Trust me.
You could start by searching Miss Barrett's private quarters, room 404, inside the Emperor's suite.
Scared me.
You better get the hell out of here, man.
selective hearing.
I can tune out just about anything. Isn't the recording studio supposed to be soundproof?
No. It's not the actual recording. It was the partying.
Last night they were playing some drinking game down the lawn.
Oh, I just popped my head out.
God damn it. Why won't you work?
Are you looking for help?
This looks interesting.
That is Ken the Brick Morgan, lawyer and corporate fixer.
I went to get a facial. The woman reeked of garlic, so that was much funny.
Oh, that's interesting. Sure.
Yeah, sorry.
Sir, you can't go through here. Please turn around. Sir, would you please walk away from here? I'd really appreciate it.
Welcome, sir. We are happy to help you in any way possible. I hope you'll enjoy the Himipan.
Okay.
change the subject then. Anyone up for a ride down the river tomorrow?
They say it's the Venice of the East, right? Wouldn't mind a little romantic boat trip myself. What do you say?
Point taken.
Yeah.
By the way,
I'm sorry, but you can't be here.
I went into town, and one of these young monks gave me quite the look. I know I'm coffee tomorrow,
but of course he's spoiled. That's sort of my point. Usually when rock stars make outrageous demands, it's because they came from nothing, and they still can't believe their luck.
Ah, the old Gatsby complex.
Exactly. But Jordan Cross was born a multi-billionaire. He grew up in a mansion with servants and chauffeurs and pilots. I mean, you'd think he was more laid back. I mean, have you seen this rider? We're one step away from Dodo Eggs.
I think it's all the manager's idea.
Dexy Barrett. Why'd it be her idea?
Well, think about it. You know, perception is everything, right? I mean, everyone knows that rock stars have ridiculous writers. So if you don't have one...
Happen to be a proper rock star. Yeah. No, I still think Cross is a spoiled brat. Besides, I like Dexy Barrett. She's got moxie, that one.
Yeah, she's something all right. Anyways, have fun getting apples that are less than 25% free.
That's not good.
Now they're not even letting guests inside.
The lounge? They closed it off?
Yeah, the Cross people. I mean, it's like they're taking over the place room by room, as if the noise wasn't enough.
It's getting rude. People pay good money to stay here. We're not second-class citizens just because the owner's son decides to pop by.
The owner doesn't give a shit. He's the head of a media empire, probably only owns this place as a tax write-off.
whatever. There's plenty of other places to go.
Sure. But I know this, won't be streaming their album.
Well, looking back, I guess it's really bad.
Straighten up! Don't slouch!
Keep your head up, working man.
So, you think it'll be a hit? The new Class album, I mean. They say the sophomore effort is always the hard one. That's when the mainstream is taking an interest and then the hardcore fans are itching to denounce you. But the stuff I've been hearing through the window sounds amazing. What do you think?
Says it's a bad idea, but what can I do? Besides, the day does get a little brighter.
I hear you.
What a strange thing to say. Here I am sharing my problems with you, and it's like you're having a completely different conversation.
Jerk.